So part of working counsel or massive action consecration is go write the applications, right? Care enough to go out there and protect some families, whether that's your warm market or whether that's leads, right? The next thing is counsel constantly. Massive action, constant correction. You know, this is the best way for me to explain this to you, and I talk about it a lot, and that there is learned knowledge and there's activity knowledge. And what I mean by that is you have to learn by doing. And so you learn a little bit, which may be the phone script. Get a phone script, get really good at it, role play with your mentor and your coach, and then go out and actually make some dials. Take some notes. What objections did you have? What did you stumble on? What did you have difficulty with? Get back on the phone with your coach or mentor, get some more learned knowledge, and then go back out and do some more activity. So it's learned knowledge, activity knowledge, and you need both in order to be successful. Again, massive action, constant correction, counsel consistently with somebody that's actually doing it. Not somebody that's reading out a book or a script or guessing. You've got to be coached by somebody that goes out there, puts the uniform every day, goes out there and sells policies, puts their name on an application just like they expect you to do. It's not a do as I say business. It's a do as I do business. And share, again, the industry with others. If you're looking to build an organization, that's a good time to do it. It's when you have success in the business, you can go out there and share it with others, and you're unstoppable if you're making good money in this industry to share it with others. So, and just kind of furthering that thought process about investing in yourself, get a tape recorder. We use tape a call a lot. When you're on these conference calls with your IMO or with your maybe your team or whatever, take notes, record the calls. That's part of being all invested and just making sure that you're a sponge in the business. And I think recording and going back, making notes, using Evernote, whatever you want to do, find it something that works for you and take good notes that you can refer back to. If you write it down, your memory retention is going to be far better. So just make a habit of recording whatever you can record in this business so you can go back and refer to it later. And plug into all the trainings. I mean, it amazes to me and plug into all the trainings. It amazes me how many times people don't take advantage of free training material from people that are actually doing it before. Going back to being a sponge. The number one priority over any sales or recruiting activity is to plug into everything, local, regional, national trainings that you can participate in, do it. And if you're with an organization that charges that training, I recommend you change and change quickly, right? Look, 99% of failure is almost assured if you're not willing to invest in yourself by being a sponge in this business and learn. No matter what you do in life, whether you go out and get a job, you're going to be learning things every day. So you should place more importance on this is your business than you would working for the job, right? So, I mean, you're forced to do it there. You're forced to go to their industry trade shows, in many cases, ongoing trainings, annual reviews, all this junk that goes on with a job. And then it seems like some people get involved in their own business and they want to do the minimum amount, but they want to get the maximum return. It doesn't work that way. You should be doing it just the opposite. You know, if you need 12 or 15 appointments in a week, book 20. You know, overdo it. Do that, you virtually assure your success. At least if it doesn't work out, it won't be because of you, right? So that's the important thing to understand there. And again, some of this stuff relies on you having the right coach and mentor, but ask questions. What do I do next? Embrace personal change. It's going to happen. Great things can come through change. There's an old saying that I love. It's almost everywhere. I don't even know that I own. And that is, until the pain of the same becomes greater than the pain of change, nothing in your life will ever change. In other words, you have to get sick and tired of being sick and tired. And until you get to that point, you can talk about it all day long. It's like smoking. Until you get really, really tired, or the pain of being a smoker outweighs the pain of change, right? You're willing to go through that change, then you're never going to stop smoking. Nothing against smoking. I'm just using it as an example, right? But understand that. Until the pain of change becomes greater than the pain of being in the same place, nothing will ever change. So I hope you get that, because it's really a good thing. So the next thing I would say is, one of the things I find a lot in this business is that I talk to people all day long, probably 30 or 40, 50 people a week, that tell me all the reasons why they need to do this. They're broke, they can't pay their bills, they are not supporting their wife properly, they're kids aren't having the best Christmas they could have, and they have all these things that really are at their core very emotional reasons as to why they want to move forward. But then when they get in the business, they use the very reason for why they got in the business, the excuse of why they're not doing the business. And what I mean by that is that as soon as a good training comes available, or as soon as your national conference comes up, or there's a conference call that you need to be on or whatever, I get the excuse, well, you know, I can't go to the conference because I really need to be with my kids. I can't go to conference because, you know, we're going on vacation. I can't go to be on the conference call because it's our dinner time. I can't be on the go to the training on Wednesday because my wife and I are supposed to be going over to our friend's house for dinner. And all of a sudden, the same reasons why you're doing this business become the reasons why you don't do the business, and that spells failure immediately. There are going to be sacrifices in this business. There's sacrifices in every journey to success. The greater the sacrifice, the bigger the reward. If you're not willing to make any big sacrifices, you're not going to get great rewards out of it, right? You have to be willing to make the investment in the bank before you can take the withdrawal. And it's going to require success. Everybody that achieves any extraordinary success in life have hit failures all along the way, and they paid a massive price. The difference is you don't see the price that they paid, right? All you see is the success. So keep that in mind. And there are four things I want to talk about on this video to kind of wrap it up is, you know, associate with the right people. This is powerful. You know, whether you're going to build an agency or not, you're going to be dealing with people. And you need to get rid of negative influences in your life. Now, sometimes that could be a spouse or a family member or a best friend. And I hate to say it, but you're going to have to push them aside because you're going to need a positive mental attitude and mindset to succeed here. It's a simple business, but it's sometimes not easy because you're going to have to, you know, you have to be self-motivated. You have to get up and go out in the field. You have to pick up the phone, especially if you're doing this business part-time. I think part-time is great, but you're working a full-time job all day long. And the last thing, if you're tired of that full-time job, you want to come home and you want to change your clothes to go out on an appointment, the TV, dinner, and all those things become real, real attractive. Or let's just say it's your weekend off from your job, and now you're going to suit up and go out there and try to protect some families. You're going to have to associate with the right people. You're going to have to associate with the right people that can encourage you and motivate you and, you know, kind of help you get through that and learn to develop the relationships, right? With people that, again, are where you want to be, right? There's no point in developing relationships with other teammates in your organization who are just as broke as you are. You need to be associating with top producers or people that are doing more than you are and reaping or having more success than you are, I guess is a word for it. You need to be with people that are having more success than you are. Someone that's having less success or the same success can't pull you along. The same goes with your coach or mentor. That's why it's so important for you to not be with somebody who's never put their name on an application, who's just a recruiter looking that you're going to be their lottery ticket to fortune and fame, right? So you've got to be someone that has never done it can't take you where they've never been. It's an important concept that you want to get across. A person cannot take you to a point where they've never been. So make sure that you are working with somebody that goes out there, suits up, puts the uniform on, and goes out there and is successful in this business. That's the person you want to be coached and mentored by, not somebody sitting in the office and telling you how to do it from the manual that he read. Okay, that's not going to work, right? And that person should have a vested interest in your success too as well. That's even more ideal because you can be assured they're not going to tell you something that's not true, right? Communicate with that person with a positive mental attitude. When they look down at the phone and your caller ID number is on there, make your phone call welcome. In other words, they're not looking to hear all the excuses. They've heard all the excuses before. What they're looking from you is asking some questions in a positive way, looking, having eager to learn and eager to be successful. Those things are welcome. To call up and say, hey, this is what I think you're doing wrong with your system and you making suggestions probably isn't going to go over very well since they're where you want to be, right? You haven't earned the right to criticize their system because obviously it's working for them, right? So just keep that in mind. Be a lifter to people's days, not a downer. There's way too many downers in the world as it is today, right? So here's the deal as I wrap this video up. I love this industry. You know that by all my other videos. If you're looking at this business part-time, fantastic. You can make a great deal of money in this business part-time. I think it's a great place to start as long as that you understand that when you get home from work and you're tired, you're going to have to make that sacrifice, suit up, and get out there and protect some families, because the part-time job is going to change your financial life potentially and get you out of that full-time grind, right? Look, if you want to make $500 a week, you can. If you want to make $1,000 a week, you can. If you want to make $2,000 a week, you can. You want to make $5,000 a week, you can. You want to make $10,000 a month, $30,000, $40,000 a month, you can do it in this business. It's just a matter of learning some basic skills, like how to take a lead and converting into an appointment. That's the number one skill. I'd rather have you be a fantastic appointment setter than know all about the products, because the products don't make any difference. You can learn the products when you get out there and get in the field. That's never going to happen if you don't know how to convert a lead on a piece of paper into a form, into an appointment that you can go visit. Stop. That's never going to happen if you can't take a lead and convert it into an appointment, put it on your calendar, and do a case strategy and get out in the field and sit kneecap to kneecap with a family in the kitchen. So the product knowledge will come. You're going to know more than they do when you go in the home anyway. And here's the reality. You're not going to need to know 50 products. You need to know the one or two products that you're going to present to them in the home, and you won't know that until after you book the appointment, find out their medical conditions, and can qualify them on a product. So as I tell my agents, what products do you want to learn before you go in the home? Doesn't make sense. You don't know what products to learn because you haven't even got your first prospect yet. Be a great appointment setter, and you'll unlock the potential to make tremendous amount of money up front in our advanced commissions. You'll unlock the potential of residual income, and where that will grow, and you'll be paid on month after month after month, long after you retire. You are in the right business to do that, and I appreciate you being on the channel here today. And listen, if there's anything I can do for you, shoot me a text, shoot me an email, pick up the phone, call me. If you're looking for an IMO or an agency, and I think they're two are separate, you need to find an agency that will work with you, and a coach or mentor that you can call, and that will work with you on how to turn you into a great appointment setter, how to help you strategize the case, how to work the rates, how to find the applications, how to get in the home, and then you can call them in the home if you have questions. That day-to-day relationship that will be all the difference for you to be successful. It's the missing ingredient in most of these IMOs out there, that you can't even call the home office, much less get any training. And the recruiter that recruits you has no training or has no knowledge because they've never sold anything. If you're looking to join the industry, we would love to talk to you. Otherwise, enjoy the channel, consume the videos. Please do me a favor, hit the subscribe button below, hit the bell, you'll get instant notifications of some live videos that we're gonna be doing, live stream stuff. And please make a comment, like the video. It helps other agents find this, because we have a lot of agents, hundreds of agents out there, thousands probably, that are in the industry with virtually zero support. And that's what this channel is for. We can help a lot of people on a wide scale basis, and we can help a few of them join our agency if they're looking for a place to go, right? So appreciate you being here, and appreciate being part of the community. Grateful that you found value in our videos. Bye-bye now.